So Cornell, I want to talk to you about this last week. This young 10-year-old, very intelligent looking young lady, a black young lady at a Pearland school who will not stand for the Pledge of Allegiance in her classroom. She doesn't want to stand up because apparently she believes that black Americans need a lot more to be done in this country. She is not willing to support the black Americans that have fought and died for this country. You know what I believe, Cornell? And I know you supported her publicly, but you know what I think? I think at 10 years old, she has no real understanding of what America is. So I wonder if her parents have sat her down and explained what Americans have given their lives, white, black, red. It doesn't make any difference. They stood and they fought and they died for this country, and she doesn't want to do anything to honor them?
Matt, she comes from a family of military service members. Her father is a retired military service member also who served this nation well with great dignity. She also has additional family members who was in the armed forces.
Good.
Her mother's a very intelligent woman who has had long conversations as well as her father about her not standing for the flag. What white people need to understand...
Just that, white people.
Yes, please. Let me explain. What white people need to understand is that that national anthem was written by Francis Scott Key, a slave owner.
Oh, here we go.
Who demonized and hated black slaves and black people. And that unwritten third, that unheard of and unspoken third verse, go research the third verse where he says, there's no refuge in this country for the hireling or the slave. Both should be turmoil to the grave.
How's her parents
this
doing?
This is a man
are they successful?
That promised turmoil for black people to the
so
grave. Would you ask Jewish children to say a pledge to a German anthem that disrespects Jewish people?
If
no, you would not.
Germany,
no,
sure.
You would not.
Well, sure.
That disrespects Jewish people?
Then
no,
why
you would not.
You certainly can kneel down. In America, you have the right to do that. But what will happen to her, how her friends will respond, how the school will view her, how Americans will view her, is very negative.
And
this is not what you want for your 10-year-old child.
And let me say to that young girl and others like that young girl, America looked at the same way at Rosa Parks when she refused to get up and give up her seat to a white man on the bus. But history vindicated her. History vindicated
her. Two different
America demonized Harriet Tubman for freeing slaves from slavery, but history vindicated her. So I say to that young girl, you stand strong, stand up, and stand for what you believe in. And to all of those who are too coward to do it, don't get in that young girl's way. Others like her, support that young girl.
What would you like her to say to the men and women who have fought for this country like I ran into over the weekend? The black men and women who fought for this country and some who gave their lives.
And ask the black men and women who served America in its military, like in the Independence War. We helped America get it, and we were still slaves afterwards. Ask those in Vietnam who gave the war on Vietnam battlefields, but then came back and was called niggers in their own country. We have fought in America's war, and we've never been given the justice and the due process of everybody else in this nation.
Then why don't you move to a different country? Why are you staying here if you don't like it?
Let me tell you why. Because the country belongs to Indians. You white folks stole it from them, raped and robbed their people. This not your country. You all came over here and stole it and beat the hell out of them. So this not your country.
It was my country.
You all need to go home.
If you're
you all need to go back where you came
if
from.
If you don't like it, why don't you pack up and go?
Let the Indians decide who should pack up and go. And I guarantee you black folks will stay and you all will be on the first damn boat leaving here. So don't try that, brother. You all didn't make America. This is not your country.
What you should do is sit down with someone who has fought for this country, Cornell. Get their opinion, too.
Tons of black people have, and what have we gotten from it?